Locomotion, in other words, the ability to move from place to place. Animals move for a variety of reasons, such as to find food, to find a suitable habitat, or to escape predators. For many animals, the ability to move is extremely essential for their survival, and hence they apply many different methods to move. We will learn about a few methods in a few of these organisms, such as amoeba, paramecium, euglena, and hydra. Locomotion in euglena. The video here has been magnified 1000 times so that you are able to get a very high definition video of euglena along with its flagellum. You will also notice the chloroplast, contractile vacuole and the big red nucleus in the center visible in a very very clear format. As you see, the flagellum is what helps the euglena move. Euglena is a unicellular organism which appears as a spindle shaped or a pear shaped organism. It swims about freely by means of a flagellum. The flagellum is held straight in front and the tip is rotated. This will pull the body of the organism forward through the water. Look at the video carefully and appreciate how the flagellum enables this euglena to move. Locomotion in paramecium. Paramecium is a protozoa that is called as a ciliate protozoa. This means paramecium moves with the help of tiny hair-like projections from the cell membrane, and these projections are called cilia. Cilia are arranged in rows and they lash through the water like tiny oars. When observed under the microscope, this unicellular organism can be seen moving rapidly, as you see in this video. Locomotion in amoeba. Amoeba, again a unicellular animal, in which the cytoplasm can be seen constantly moving. Just like in this video, you are able to see that the cytoplasm inside the cell membrane of the amoeboid cell is constantly moving. And this flowing cytoplasm presses against the cell membrane, producing a number of finger-like projections called pseudopodia. The other name for pseudopodia is false feet. Rest of the cell then follows. So what happens over here is, as the cytoplasm moves inside the cell membrane, there are finger-like projections called pseudopodia that are produced, and hence the cell by itself moves. This type of locomotion, which is achieved by changing the shape of the cell, is called as amoeboid movement. In this video, you will be able to see how the pseudopodia help in engulfing food and making the food become a food vacuole. Eventually, the food gets digested and becomes a part of the cell. Locomotion in multicellular organisms like hydra is quite interesting. Hydra moves in two ways, by somersaulting and by looping. In the somersaulting motion, the hydra bends over, attaches the tentacles to the surface, loosens the base, swings the base over the mouth and attaches itself to the surface again. After loosening the tentacles, it repeats the process, and this is somersaulting. In looping, hydra will bend over, attach the tentacles to the surface, drags its base towards the mouth and then loosens the tentacles to stand upright. Interesting.